Welcome to our Kartik Inspiration, Day 25. I'm so happy that we are together since all this time now, because it's something like a community, a Vrindavan community that appears out of all of this. Today we will talk about the forest without envy. The greatest happiness in life is when we somehow can put Krishna into the center, and that may mean to remove our own interests out of the center. To see everything in relationship to Krishna protects us also against that one thing which really can spoil our life, that is envy on others. In Vrindavan, Krishna is in the center, and therefore everyone is happy. Prabhupada writes, "The calf is happy, the cat is happy, the dog is happy, the man is happy, everyone. Everyone wants to serve Krishna in a different capacity, and thus there is no envy." And then he talks about the monkeys. One may think that the monkeys cause mischief and steal food and they are a nuisance. But he says how this vision is all accommodating. He says, in Vrindavan we find that even the monkeys are allowed to take butter, which Krishna himself distributes. Krishna personally demonstrates that everyone has the right to live. This is Vrindavan life. Yes, this is Vrindavan life. Putting Krishna in the center and losing envy. Srila Prabhupada, very early when he came to America, brought this consciousness along with him and said this consciousness is called Yoga Staha. Translation, to be situated in yoga, in a higher connection. How we can put Krishna into the center of our life is something which is not difficult. You just have to connect what you do with Krishna. When you buy vegetables, think, this is for Krishna. I will prepare meals, offer them, and then take them to be strong, to do service for Krishna. When you go to work, don't think, "Ah, no, I have to see all these people which I don't like to see." See, I'm working now for Krishna. The whole idea is very much comprised in a simple word, Namaha. When you offer obeisances, you say Namaha. Not me, but you. I suggest that we all think about one conscious effort that we do, where we put really Krishna into the center. Why not pay an obeisances and do this obeisances for Krishna? Or you may do your little Damodar Puja and consciously understand, I'm standing before my Lord and I'm now performing an Aratik ceremony for his pleasure. Once you start doing this, you can build up from there so that finally you live a Vrindavan life. Thank you all very much and see you all tomorrow.